sports. It's in the game.
Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
Money, I need more. Don't want your bro. It was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need more. Don't want your bro. It was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need more. Give them a show. Your bro. I'm taking your man and spinning his bands. Oh yeah, did it again. Oh yeah, out with his friend. Oh yeah, Chanel is the lens.
Okay.
With his friend finna get lit. I'm everything on they wish list. Which bag should I get? Which color should I pick? Any, mini, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. You big bro, gotta go. Big bird giving crow. A group of baddies coming foe. Give me money, kiss my toes. Go with your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro. It was for show. Just so you know. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give them a show. Killing you knows and taking your bro.
Religion was the moon, made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy, called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough, grew up with the homeschooler. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa, chiller. Click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Trying to make a killer, stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling.
Hey, Belly, them ready? Yeah.
When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just
how I'm feeling. Them get a red eye, never make right. Me and they are suffering life, them I get by. Never bow for the fame, heads high. Never come so all them I see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gonna switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like steel. I'ma grow tough. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, twiddle be so dumb. I'ma be a giant P5-4 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy like Lauren Hill. Me, I kill them softly. This a girl running. Cause if I'm too loyal, then it's gonna cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that they make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross? Don't you ever get it crisscross? Don't you ever get it crisscross? I got the pump that to make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross? Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the cow. I find then I get love.
that's how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Well, they say an early season snowstorm may be on deck in less than 48 hours, but today is picture-perfect fall football weather, crisp and cool at Soldier Field in the Windy City. This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel. Ready for football are they, and ready for football are we as the Bears get set to match up with the Green Bay Packers. It's a rivalry that dates back to 1921. The Packers and Bears are underway from Chicago. Jackson now to return. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He finds Hopkins complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. And the Bears are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
Brings up second and 8. The
8 yards to go on second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And some room to work. And he will take this all the way down to the Packers' 16-yard line. 46 yards rushing for him now in his first 2 carries in the ballgame. Well, we have seen some rookie running backs come in and have a big impact year one, and this guy would certainly fit that bill, as that was one heck of a run there.
And what I really enjoyed about that run and what made it so impressive to me was how he improvised along the way. Sometimes on a big play, you just get the football and you take off in a straight line and go. But this time, how about the artistry of that play? That looked a little bit like a Picasso to me.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. The excellent play last time is followed by a much more routine gain of 3. The last run got 3. Now here's second and 7.
Tight
Here's Fields. He's got the hookup with Conley. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Short completion, just 4 yards. And that'll lead here to a third down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there, but of course you're going to give it to him.
Santos' kick is up and through, and it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. Had just the one big play on the drive, but that was enough to put him in field goal range.
Yeah, one big play of what they hope will be many others throughout the game. Every team has a different target for the number of plays like that, those explosives that we talk about. That allowed him to put points on the board on that drive. Let's see how the rest of the game goes.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the...
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal. And they'll run again. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. A great effort there. With a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Bears are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Santos with the extra point. And the lead grows to 10-0. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. Jackson now to return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try and get things settled down a little bit.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. And worth pointing out, after that last completion, that puts this young quarterback over 10,000 yards passing for his career. And fair to say, he's not done yet.
No doubt about it. He's really just getting started because he's not quite into the prime of his career. So it's likely he's going to hit a few more of these milestones as this career progresses. So let's face it, we'll acknowledge this number and we'll celebrate the milestones down the road.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. This defense for the Bears, they were terrific a week ago in that win over Detroit.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, 6. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top.
And here's another interception, the 3rd of this first quarter. Picked off near the 29. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Now Fields. caught here by Conley. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
Well, this offense will definitely utilize him as a weapon out of the backfield because he was close to 100 yards receiving a week ago. So they will try to get him to football in space as they did right there.
They'll run on first down. Conley, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. These two teams, they met up earlier in the year back in week two, and it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home. To throw is Fields. And he rifles one incomplete. So, CD, you talk about this football team and some of the whispers and reports, the social media posts, they hint at a locker room that's splintered, badly splintered. There was talk earlier, some guys might walk away entirely, but that hasn't happened, however, at least to this point.
No, and sometimes some of that talk is just that, talk. I mean, guys often say, that's it, I'm out of here, and then they realize, I'm not ready to retire yet. What am I going to do now? And they're really ready to come back and dive back in. In fact, we've got guys who are wearing gold jackets in the Hall of Fame that talked about retirement the last 6-7 years of their career. So that's not always real. And sometimes you just have to go ahead and ride it out. And this is an opportunity now for everyone in this locker room to move forward.
Nothing the score after one on EA Sports. And the first play will be a field goal try. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And three interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. They'll drop the throw. DeAndre Hopkins making the catch. And they work this well upfield across the 45. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. That catch, by the way, number 940 in his career. So he's 60 away from a grand, but 940, that ties him with Art Monk.
And I think it's fitting that he tied Art Monk because of the way that he goes about his business, the way that he plays the game. Not a lot of flash, not a lot of dash, but plenty of production.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Back to throw again. Open man left side. It's a tight end, Tonyan. 7 yards to pick up there. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Touchdown, Packers! Antonio Gibson with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Packers are back within a score. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is, his first miss, no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This will be fielded inside the 5. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's got Rome. And he will take this all the way down to the Packers 30. 113 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. So that run there, yeah, I don't know if it's overstating things to call it a thing of beauty, but in terms of football plays, that's as good as you're going to see.
And what I really enjoyed about that run and what made it so impressive to me was how he improvised along the way. Sometimes on a big play, you just get the football and you take off in a straight line and go. But this time, how about the artistry of that play? That looked a little bit like a Picasso to me.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for 1st and 10. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And they move this all the way down to the 9.
The speed with which this offense could get down the field. It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up for the 1st and goal.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal, and he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. A nice pickup of 6 there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be 2nd and goal. He'll try again, and he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on 3rd and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 2nd quarter. From the 3-yard line again, they'll try and punch it in here on 3rd and goal. Back to throw, Fields. Forced out to his left. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Justin Fields, a 3-yard touchdown run, and the Bears will extend their lead. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2-minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do. when you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And this is going to fall to the ground, incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll set up to throw. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Throwing the out route, incomplete. That's Campbell. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. It's complete to Hopkins. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up, because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That's out to the flat for Gibson. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
They'll look to throw again. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. That was the eighth play of the drive, so a somewhat fitting pickup of 8 yards.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. They'll try to run with Gibson. And no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the 1. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Second and 1. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Packers are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here we go. Here we go. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll finally be taken down just shy of midfield. So we come upon halftime here at Soldier Field with the Bears out in front. As we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. This one fielded at the 5. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23. At their own 23-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be license to take some shots downfield.
Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters? This week, he kind of said, I've had enough. And I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Fields now to throw. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big play there on the catch and run.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing, and they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 38. Now it's Fields. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
On first down, Fields. Throw right side here, taken in by Bateman. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3 at the 17.
On 2nd down now, Conley. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
They'll keep it on the ground. Conley, he is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beefeaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chops on 3rd and short, and yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stuffing that one short of a first down.
Santos' kick is up and through. And that will extend their lead even further. So that's 3 field goals for him now, but heck, he's not even halfway to his career best of 7.
Seems like the 7 field goal games are the kind of games I always get assigned to in my other job. Let's hope for this offense's sake, they can start cashing in on a few of these drives.
Go, go, go. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Now their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. We're glad you're with us from Soldier Field in Chicago. Third quarter here, second and 10. Play action, they'll throw, and he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down. And that'll be marked down as their first sack of the game.
Well, they had six last week, and this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back. And they did a great job in the first half. And now they've gotten their first sack here in the second half. Look out, they'll try to increase the pressure.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and the Bears take over. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead, but that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards. On first down, Conley. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Tanner Mews there defensively.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
They'll keep it on the ground. Conley. So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Here's Fields. Buying time to his left. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
Throwing on third down, Fields. Hard throw, incomplete.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So he's got another field goal, his fourth now in the game. He's making it look easy out there.
He certainly is, and they're always aiming for a swing of the leg that repeats under pressure, right? So nothing's different. He's got that right now because confidence is breeding confidence.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. He'll look to throw. He'll dump that off to Gibson, complete.
And he'll get it down here to the 43. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Now here's a throw that's complete. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to go up top for the end zone. Touchdown, Packers! Paris Campbell hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Packers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed. And in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31. You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well. If you do that, that's really going to lead you to more issues.
They'll run on first down. Conley. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the Improv and you run into a tough crowd.
And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
The Bears on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and five. Fields dancing to his left. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Eric Kendricks. And the Packers are right back in this football game. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Flushed out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
He'll look to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receiver. And force the incompletion.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now here's a whistle as flags come in. And we'll check out the call. Here now, Johnny Townsend, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this is a beauty, as that ball's going to angle out at the 6-yard line.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
On first down, Conley. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it, and let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And they're going to have a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Fields on third down. Open man is Kmet, the tight end. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or a takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
No room to be had there on the first down run as he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll be faced with a third and inches. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
They'll keep it on the ground. Conley. And this will be a Bears first down as they'll take this up to the 38-yard line. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5. And now this defense trying to use the clock to their advantage. They'll take the timeout here with 2:08 left. And then they'll have another stop coming up at the two-minute warning. Working with second and 5 now. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down. Here's Pat O'Donnell now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. They'll call that a 33-yard. With no return, and it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
Back to throw. Being chased out left. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. And I know it seems like we say this a lot in broadcast booths, but a quarterback can hold on to the football too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football, save some yardage to make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hipped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
This will be taken in by Hightower. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. So down 6, and they know they need this one on fourth down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off around the 37. Talk about making
making winning plays. That is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that, because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. The win for the Bears just around the corner. They go down to a knee.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And this coaching staff, CD, I think you'd agree, pleased with this overall effort.
I think they're more than pleased, right? They've got to look at each other like, wow, we just pulled this.